CSS has always been a place where people come with their requirements. They come with, you know, I want to do this and this and this and this. And if you scream out loud for a long enough time, then you maybe get what you want. At the same time, it's very hard to change things because there's a lot more people screaming. And the number of ideas is always higher than the capacity, both the capacity to describe things in technical documentation and also to implement it. The lead time, the development time from an idea until it's out there is much longer now. I feel, you know, happy that I was there in the beginning when we could, you know, change something one night and have it, you know, go into specs the next week and implement it a month after that. Now things do take longer time, but I think there will be, CSS will be evolving, new things will be added, and I also think that it will be with us for a very long time. I think that the CSS code that we write today, even the code we wrote 20 years ago, I think that computers will be able to read that very long into the future. I kind of made this bet that if you go into a computer store 500 years from now, you can't even think about it, right? What is it going to be like? Are we going to have computer stores? I don't know. But if you have a computer 500 years from now, it will be able to read the CSS code that we write today. Of course, 500 years is a convenient thing for me to say because, you know, nobody can tell me I'm wrong. And I'm not going to be around 500 years from now, so nobody can tell me I'm wrong. In the future either, but it's not a random number, because if you go 500 years back in time, then we get back to the Gutenberg of the 1400s, who developed this fantastic machine to create printed books. And those books, we know how to use them. We know how to, you know, fold the pages. We know how to read from top to bottom. So the user interface has remained the same, and we can still decode the books that Gutenberg printed, just the same way as I think computers of the future and humans of the future are going to be able to read the content that we write today. And that's why, you know, you should be proud of your code. As a developer, you should make sure that you write the right kind of CSS code that you're proud of now, and that you want to make sure that, you know, in 500 years, your grandchildren are going to be proud of what you did. So take care of the code, be gentle to the computer, and make beautiful stuff on your screens.